Here we are going to have some fun with Revit Conduit. I'm just in my home screen here, and I'm going to go File, New Project, and I'm going to pick a out-of-the-box Imperial system template that has all my MEP stuff in there. And if I hit OK, that opens up. That has all of my duct and pipe and conduit and cable tray kind of Autodesk out-of-the-box families loaded. It's always important that we have these families loaded down here. And we're talking about conduit here. And within conduit, we have two different types. This is unlike any other of the MEP elements. Duct are not this way, nor are pipes, because we have conduit with fittings, which have like real elbows and parts and stuff. And then we have conduit without fittings. Without fittings are basically bent conduit. So a lot of the same materials, but these are bent with couplings, basically, is what these are. So they all have their fittings stored in here, okay? And their fittings are all in here, elbows and T's and junction boxes. And these are all grouped together, regardless of their material. And then these are specified down in here by double-clicking on any one of these. And this is where you have your routing for the conduit, a little bit different from duct and piping. So bends and T's and crosses, and then these families, of course, are selected, which are back from our conduit families up inside of here. So you specify for this particular type of conduit what the elbows are. Now, keeping in mind that the without fittings, the elbows are really just bends. And even though they are bent, we should still stick to nominal angles. We're going to talk about that quickly. So, and also with scheduling, with fittings, your conduit length will give you different lengths because the elbows are not conduit, they're actually fittings, right? Where these are bends, so the conduit goes all the way around the corner. So you're going to get longer conduit length in the same run between these two because these would exempt the fitting elements themselves. So when we go to draw, we can go to our system tab and we can go up here to our electrical. And what I'm gonna do is pull that guy right off and put it down over here. And then I can say conduit, and then I can pick my conduit type off of here, which is one of these guys. So let's go with a bent one. So we'll go conduit without fittings, and let's just go RMC, rigid metal conduit. And now pick our size on here, and you have to remember these have to be real sizes. So, you know, maybe a 2-inch, and let's start, you know, low at maybe 3 feet. And as I draw, I have to always keep in mind the bending radius that it's using, because it has to have enough room to get around the corners, literally elbow room. So if you try to transition too quickly, it won't have enough room. So I can click on here and, oh, what's going on? I don't know what type of view I'm in. Hit escape, escape. Okay, oh, I'm in, look, I'm in a mechanical view. I'm getting too excited here. Close that down. I want to go maybe to a power view. There we go. Then conduit's turned on in that particular view based on the view of that could be filter or just turning the categories off with our visibility graphics inside of here. So in here, I can draw my conduit again. Everything gets remembered from the last time, and I click on here and I start to draw, and look, it's putting it in medium detail. So I'm just clicking along, and I happen to have enough room to get those elbows in, and then maybe I do want to jump up to 9 feet. Now I'm up to 9 feet. There's a riser there, you can see. And then if I hit escape, I'm out. And then if I go, let's close this mechanical view, let's close, open the 3D view. Let's type WT to tile my views, WT, ZA, zoom all. Okay, so there's my conduit that I've drawn. Let's change our scale to be fine detail in both of these views. Okay, then I can kind of see a little more detail. So conduit without fittings is just kind of bent, right? There's no, even though that's a family in Revit and it's an elbow, okay, and if you delete it, it's a piece. But generally, you don't see the seam lines in here graphically. Okay, so now if I zoom out and I do another conduit, But this time I pick one with fittings. Okay, let's go with fittings. Let's go with this one here, RMC, and with fittings. And then I can, you know, do the same type of thing over here. What I'm at 9 feet, and let's drop down to 3 feet. Okay, hit escape, escape. Okay, so it's gonna put actual real pieces in there. These are actual aluminum elbows, whereas these guys over here are bends. So this is gonna schedule a little bit different. And then in this one, I might even pull a box off of there, click, and then because I'm at a lower elevation, you can see it put the riser in, escape, escape on that. So that's same thing, but putting my junction box inside of there. And the next fun thing we might want to do is change the service type and then use a filter to color these guys. It's really neat. So watch, let me just grab this as an example. Hover tab, click to grab all those. And I'm going to change the service type of that to be maybe power. Okay, click out. Now I'm going to grab this one, hover tab, click. And I'm going to make a new service type up and just call this, you know, high voltage. Because I can. And then click out. Okay, so now I have new service types in there. Then I can go into my visibility graphics, VV, and if I have a filter ready and waiting, I can go in here and say add, and I can say electrical, high voltage and power, add them both in, and then I can turn them on or off, but I can also go in here and change the line pattern and the color. So I can make my power be red and hit OK. And then I can make my high voltage blue and hit OK on there. And then OK and apply and OK. And there we have it. So now all I have to do in each view, if I wanted to, I could create a view template. But VV in here, I could go into filters and then add and then go add those guys in and then add the color and stuff. I don't want to take the time to do that, but quick and easy conduit with and without fittings and adding our service types and color.